friends, welcome to my channel or welcome back to my channel. I am Sarah Martin with The Contoured Chemist. Today we're talking about Seint Beauty and 3D foundation. What I see most in terms of application, and one of the greatest things about cream makeup is you can't make mistakes because they are super easy to fix. So I'm gonna show you kind of what I see most, and I'm gonna show you how to fix little mistakes or tweaks, if you will, because there are no mistakes when it comes to makeup, but it will help in case you ever deal with any of the issues. And then on the other side, I'm gonna show you how to avoid those issues from the first place. If you wanna check it out, please keep watching. Be sure to like and subscribe, and thanks for being here. Okay, friends, have you seen this before? I know y'all have. This is what we like to call in Seint world the finger paint method, or the paint by numbers. If it's in dot forms, they call it the cheetah hack. There are a lot of different names for it, but I'm gonna kind of explain to you how this can maybe lead to some issues, whether it's under application, over application, trouble blending, feeling sticky or tacky, not being able to see a differentiation between colors, like actually getting that highlighted and contoured look that the whole point of this is to get. Sometimes it can give you an all one color. No dimension is what I hear the most. I mostly hear also not good coverage. I've heard many things over the years. It's been 6 years of teaching this method, and I'm gonna show you how I recommend if you're a beginner. Because even though this is truly shown by so many artists because it's to show you the ease of application and placement is not hard, and to show you how easy this makeup can be, I find it probably one of the worst methods for beginners to try. It leads to more issues than it solves. So, once you become seasoned with this makeup and you have perfected your application, by all means, try it for yourself, see if you like it. It can be a really quick and easy method for those days that you want 1 to 3 minute makeup, but you don't care if it looks absolutely perfect. So if you don't know, if you are new here, I'm a little bit of a recovering perfectionist, and I'm type A, and I like to give you guys all the information. And what I've discovered over the years is that this can just lead to a lot of issues if you don't understand the way the makeup works. And so I teach different methods so that you avoid all issues from your first application instead of you coming to me and be like, I hate this makeup. I promise I can teach anyone to love this makeup if you're willing to try different methods, because this truly is not my favorite method. It doesn't work best for me if I am really wanting my makeup to look its best. And so that's why you don't see me teaching this very often. I've shown it many, many times, but it isn't my favorite. So I'm gonna kind of show you, if you've tried this and you're kind of wanting to tweak the way your makeup is looking, I'm gonna show you how to tweak this side. And then I'm gonna show you how I recommend to avoid those issues on the other side. All right, still with me? Let's do this. So all this is I'm taking my 3D foundation, and I even kind of cheated a little bit and I did use 3 highlights like I will show you over here. And I did use my, what I call the color correcting shade, which is my darkest highlight. And I did use it on a few parts of my face that are darker and need correction. Most artists won't show you that. It's a non-negotiable for me in order for my makeup to even last on my face for more than 2 hours. So I did use that on my darkest points first, and then I went ahead and used my main highlight shade, which most artists will show you a main highlight and a brightener shade. So that brightener is the lightest shade, and then your main highlight everywhere else. And then that contour color, I just swiped in with my finger and I swiped it where contour goes. Now, I kept it really simple and I just did contour along my forehead, under the cheekbone, and under the jaw. So this is the basics of 3D foundation. You are using like that three formation to sculpt out your face with contour. You can apply it all in one layer so that you really learn that placement. You can grab a brush and then you can blend, okay? So the first thing I would say is this is a really great method to learn placement if you have never contoured before. Most definitely, okay? Just because sometimes it helps people to follow the face map that we have on the website and just kind of draw it on the face and blend it out. I'd say if you're doing this method, there's probably only a couple brushes I would recommend using to blend this. You're gonna want something dense so that you can blend it out easily. Anything that's too loose bristle-wise is not the best for blending. And so I would say, I see a lot of people use the buff brush. This brush to me lends to people swiping, then they tell me there's no coverage. When in fact, this is the most full coverage brush, but it's all in how you use it. This method can make this brush more difficult to use. I would say I would pick up the rounded end of the 3D brush or the blush end of the blush and bronzer. Since this is the top selling brush, and to be honest, the only brush I don't use on a daily basis, I'm gonna show you how I blend with this. Now, I'm not saying this is a bad brush. I am saying that it's not my favorite because it can give, again, issues. This entire video is gonna be how to avoid issues that you can easily avoid, right? So a lot of people apply with this. And again, this end, when people are blending, they tend to pull. This end tends to streak the cream on the skin. Streaking, anytime you see streaking, that is just a matter of application and the brush you're using. These creams never streak on me, but I don't ever recommend swiping with these creams. Now this end, on the other hand, is great. In my opinion, it's a more dense, smaller version of the blush brush, which this is what I do recommend for beginners, but I'll get there in a minute. So I am gonna show you this end of the 3D brush to blend. It is a nice dense brush. It lends to blending really well. So one of the things about this side is that you wanna blend in a certain order. I recommend blending out your highlight first, then moving to contour, and then lip and cheek. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and just start blending. Now, one of the things I see the most is people doing this. Like I just said, I don't recommend swiping. I don't know if you can see very closely, but when you swipe, that didn't really streak, but it can lead to streaking or just simply pulling the makeup off your skin to where you're like, I don't see any good coverage there, okay? So what I recommend instead is where you have that highlight, you use a stippling motion, okay? If you want the most natural coverage, I would take this brush and you actually wanna buff it. So I like this end of this brush because you truly can do any motion, and the motion will give you the type of coverage you want. So if you want natural, you wanna buff it into the skin. Okay, that's gonna give you the thinnest application of the makeup. If you have more mature skin like me, or you're wanting to build up a coverage a little bit more, you wanna kind of stipple, which is this pouncing motion, in order to kind of blend it out. I'm gonna attempt to kind of buff in areas I have put that main highlight on. Just see if you can see a difference in application. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see in this look. I do have natural light, but sometimes it's hard to see truly how it's sitting on the skin. Okay, where you have pores, try to press, okay? So I'm pretty much hitting those points where I have that main highlight first. Now I did put my color corrector on some of these points because I knew any shade I put there is going to get really textured. Now, kind of the issue with this, in my opinion, is that the colors just seem to blend together really easily when you have them. Like, I have a color corrector here, my main shade here, my brightener here. This brush doesn't fit real well around the eye. So again, people use this pointed end. It does fit really well. Just don't pull. If you're pulling around the eye like that, it's really gonna streak and give you very little coverage. So kind of tap. Out that shade. I've hit all of the points that are my main shade or my corrector. So I'm gonna go ahead and just do this area since this had my brightener as well. You'll see a lot of people say just concentrate a corrector where you need it and your brightener shade where you don't. For me, I don't know if you can see how, hopefully you can see the difference when I show you on this side, my difference in coverage. I'm just gonna keep going. To half my face. Okay, so you can see so far I've blended out my highlights and you can see I have coverage. I'm not saying this method does not give coverage. This makeup is easy to apply. This makeup can be super simple and you know a few tips and tricks. Okay, so I missed some main shade right there. I'm gonna have to blend that with my lip and cheek because it's too close to get in there. Okay, so let's go ahead and move to contour. I guess I kind of blended part of it. It was right here. Okay, I'm gonna pull that down my neck. I don't know if you can see that it was kind of on the side of my face. Make sure that's blended out. You don't want a stripe here. You want to make sure it's under your jawline, okay? Then the easiest part is, in my opinion, the forehead. It's hard to mess up a forehead unless you just don't. If you just do this, you'll notice it blends away. The other thing I see is this. Got all over the place. But I'm gonna show you how to fix it. So blend up. Don't swipe back and forth. That will just blend everything together, okay? And when you get to lip and cheek, okay, this motion is just gonna spread it around. Okay, so this is what I see most of the time, which can be successful when you first blend out your highlight, second, contour, lip and cheek last. Things to avoid: blending like this, or being too willy-nilly with your stripes. If you are barely tapping in and dotting on your face, you're going to blend that out and be like, I thought this makeup's supposed to have really good coverage. There are a few things that this can result in, things you need to quote unquote fix, okay? Now, in my opinion, this side looks better than my old makeup ever did. I've got a nice glow. I've got some dimension in my face, even though things aren't exactly the best placement. Or blend it out, I don't have a lot of dimension. A little bit under my eyes since I did put a lot of brightener there. So if I really zoomed in close, I don't know if you can see I feel like it doesn't do justice with how it looks in person. My under eyes look, I've got some creasing already happening. Kind of looks a little cakey under my eyes. Not the best coverage, especially through here and here. Not really any contour definition, just a little bit of shadow, but it's gone in. It's a little low, a little far in. I'm gonna have to clean that up. I don't really have any dimension on my forehead. I don't know if you can see how it's sitting in my pores, making my hyperpigmentation stand out, okay? Just a few things that I can easily fix, but I'd say I actually swiped in and put a good amount of highlight on for coverage. The two things I most frequently see is that either you feel like you don't have enough coverage after, or you feel like it's too much on your face. And so those are two completely different things that you would fix in two different ways. For the most part, it doesn't look bad at all. You can see how much coverage I got. Fast, glowy. I can easily tweak this. So let's see. First issue, if you have, we're gonna act like we don't have enough coverage, okay? For one area, for sure, I don't have good coverage on my hyperpigmentation. I'd say in here either. Now, one thing you have to be careful about is if you go in with your brightener first on any darker areas, if you're putting a lighter shade and then you put something darker over it, it's not gonna work the same way as if you were to put the darker shade on first, then put a brightener shade. So I recommend for all my clients, especially more mature skin, that if you have depth and darkness under your eyes especially, unless you just have naturally really light under your eyes, which I actually do, I just have a lot of depth as well from my dark circles and hyperpigmentation. So I did put a color corrector right there. So that's why that area right there doesn't look too bad. I just didn't get any coverage really through here because that is where my brightener was. And those lighter shades just can't cover darker tones like a darker tone can't, right? So that's why we use color correction. If you are matching the darkest point of your face with a corrector first, then you can put that brighter shade over it and it's actually going to show less texture around your eyes. You're gonna be able to use both products a lot less as well. So I'll show you when I get to this side how we do that. But when you're trying to fix this side, you wanna be really careful with layering a darker highlight shade over a lighter one. That can give you texture. Remember, the lighter the highlight, the more it can emphasize texture on your face. It's always safer to go a little darker, stick with your main shade in those areas, and then you can brighten after you've got the coverage you want. I don't find the lighter shades give much coverage. Now granted, my main shade, I'm using a brightener three shades lighter. A shade three shades lighter than my skin tone is not gonna give the coverage like my main shade will. I use an even darker shade, one shade darker than my main, to correct because my main does not have great undertones at correcting depth, purple, blue, redness, none of those things. It tends to look ashy without my corrector shade. So if you're finding that you're using a main shade and it starts breaking up in areas of your face during the day, or it just wears off of certain areas of your face really quickly, that's usually a sign that you need a darker shade, maybe on certain points of your face. I'm gonna be really light-handed. I'm gonna grab a smaller brush so that I can just hit. So this is the blend brush, and I'm just gonna try to be strategic and hit those areas I need more coverage on. Okay, so since I have this hyperpigmentation around my eyes, I need to correct that first before I can blend a bunch of highlight shades together that aren't gonna give me good coverage on those darker points, if that makes sense. So I'm just gonna go ahead and press on. Okay, so we talked earlier about the motion of the brush. This is gonna be a really natural, so just remember, buffing is going to like almost spread out that highlight shade in the thinnest way possible, so it's gonna give you the most sheer coverage, okay? Most natural finish. When you start pressing, this is what's gonna build up that cream and build up that coverage on those areas. So if you don't have enough coverage with this method, go in, first of all, get yourself a corrector. Second of all, go in and press on only where you need the most coverage, okay? I did apply my corrector on this side of my nose, so it's not looking too textured here. Broken capillaries, this area tends to be an area that is really easily a place that we don't get enough coverage, where your redness might start peeking through, where the highlight might look textured immediately when putting it on. So just by using a darker shade there, it's gonna mitigate that problem. And I did use, I have a rosacea on the edge of my chin here. I did use a little bit through here, but you saw I had my contour straight on my face. So that's why you are seeing the hyperpigmentation kind of through my skin in this area. Now, I'll be honest, I can't fix that because I've already applied my contour there. I'll show you how I avoid that on this side, but I can't really fix that unless I was gonna wipe it off and start over. I don't recommend really applying corrector over your contour. You're really just kind of gonna muddy up that area if you are, you start putting your corrector over that when you've already applied your contour, if that makes sense. Now you can fix where you applied your contour. So it doesn't matter what brush you use, you can stick with this. I would say just use your main shade. And do you see how low this contour is? Okay, I'm gonna go, since contour goes, if you don't know, when you roll something, it goes, should be going from about the top of your ear to the side of your mouth, so right here. And since the contour is down here, take your main shade, go from about the middle of your ear, and then pull that, and that line, and including right here, I like to stop about the corner of my eye, we wanna avoid it getting in this mustache region, right? So pull it, use that highlight and clean that line up so you kinda have a good idea of where that contour should be. Now it looks like I have kind of a little bit of a shadow, but it's a little bit unblended as well. So I'm gonna go in, first of all, I'm gonna go in with my blush brush this time. I'm gonna go in with my main shade and I'm just going to press that now that I have that point and I know where that contour needs to stop. And I'm just gonna kind of build up a little bit of coverage there and use this brush to kind of blend that out. Okay, easy peasy. Now, we can even go right into that brush that we used to blend that contour and you can blend it up, okay? So first I would start by just trying to press to blend or flick that brush upwards to see if you can get that line to not look so distinct. And you'll see how easily these creams blend. In fact, sometimes it's an issue that because we did this motion, you'll see you almost blend it all out to where you don't see any shadow anymore. It widened it too much. It lowered our face. Our whole point is to keep this lifted, right? So by pressing or just barely touching the face and flicking, you can easily kind of blur that line without taking away the contour. So a lot of times when I'm hearing people say there was not a whole lot of dimension, they're over blending their contour or they're kind of blending together all of their highlights, trying to do that one layer application. Greatest things about this makeup is that there's a million different ways to apply it. You just have to kind of try it for yourself and experiment. That is literally my motto. Experiment, find a method that you love that works for you. Since all of our skin is so different, one of the reasons why I found the methods that work for me is because a lot of these methods didn't work for me in the best way. I don't have beautiful, even skin tone without redness, hyperpigmentation. I'm aging. I don't have, you know, under eyes that are completely flat where I can put my brightener directly all over my under eyes and get it to sit. Like, sorry, but some 20-year-olds can. I'm not 20. There are way different methods when it comes to application. If you do have more mature skin, or if you do have any skin issues that need more coverage. This makeup is very pigmented. It can give incredible coverage, anywhere from natural to full coverage. That's why I love it. But it's definitely depends on how you're applying it. And the brush choice is huge. It's like, I pick this for a natural day. I pick this for a medium coverage day. This one for full coverage. How I use the brush, it all makes a difference, okay? Okay, so I feel like my contour already looks a lot better, okay? Now, a lot of times I also hear, I can't see my blush. Now, if you did not see, this is the blush I used. That is Dahlia. Can you see it? No, you really can't. I'll show you how I strategically place my blush, I guess you could say, because I find that a lot of people that use this method and are blending their blush like this, they're saying that they can't like see their blush within 15 minutes, okay? So I'm gonna have to apply more blush. I am not going to put it on like this. I just put more coverage here, which I feel like I need to maybe put a little bit more on. A little bit more of my mane, okay? Now I don't wanna move that, okay? So now I'm going to put on a little bit more blush strategically, okay? Meaning I'm going to tap in, make sure I can see it at least on my brush, okay? And what I love about these cream blushes is that even our most pigmented shades like this, you can apply a little bit and get a sheer wash of color. You can build it up. You can get as much or as little blush. If you're a blush girl, I know you wanna see it. If you're like me, I like a very, like a pop of color, but nothing too harsh. So let's go to the apples of the cheeks, and this time we're just going to lightly tap, and I'm barely tapping my skin. Okay, and then as we move, then we can press it on, okay? Now you can see my blush, okay? No harsh edges. When you use your fingers and you tap it on like that, you almost have to use a dense brush to blend it out, or you're gonna see it's just gonna stay right where you put it, right? So by touching the blush brush, this is blush brush, to the blush, you can really easily just press it on exactly where you want it, and then just build up that color until it's the way you like it. You don't have to worry about, oh, okay, I blended it all out, now I gotta go apply more. You can apply the right amount from the first step, right, upon application. Okay, I'm much happier with this side. Let's go ahead and apply to this side so I can show you guys how I would apply a little bit different to get it the way I want. And I will be honest, even though this method seems very fast, I get a lot of questions where people are like, oh, but doesn't your method take a lot longer? I have videos on here that I do it blindfolded. It doesn't take longer as soon as you learn it. With anything, a new method of makeup application is going to be a little trial and error. It's going to take you a little bit longer the first time you apply. But the more you apply it, I can apply this way full face, 3 minutes flat. It doesn't take me any longer. In fact, I think it takes me less time because I don't have to worry so much about blending later to get it the way I want or to fix any kind of little mistakes along the way. I apply, blend at the same time, and it always looks exactly the way I want it. So first things first, one of the things is avoiding too much product. I find that most people who initially try this product apply way too much. And I feel like it doesn't really matter if you're using a brush or your fingers. This makeup is just different. It is way more pigmented than a traditional foundation. So I think people are surprised at how very little you actually need to use. But the beauty of it is, unlike traditional foundation that dries down, sets, and evaporates, this doesn't. So you can keep manipulating it or applying more until it's exactly the way you like it. It's not gonna set and like stay put. You can easily adjust it like we just did, okay? So this side, I'm gonna use my corrector the way I like to use it, which is more of like a base for the darkest points of my face. And you'll see, I have other videos showing just the wear time with my makeup, the coverage I can get, and it's just using a color corrector. Okay, so I am gonna use my Mango, which is my corrector, the blush and bronzer, which is the brush I recommend for beginners, and then the only other brush I'm gonna use is the detail brush. These two, I think, are perfect for any beginner. You can contour, you can bronze, you can apply lip and cheek, highlight, and get anything from natural to full coverage with these two brushes. It gives you the most versatility and it leads to the least amount of troubleshooting. All right, so when it comes to this method, number one thing you gotta know is do not swipe into these creams. Getting the right amount on your brush is the first step in learning how to apply this makeup and not get too much. It is so easy to kind of build up your coverage, but it is much harder to take away. So if you are new to the makeup and you've applied a few times and you still feel like it feels heavy or tacky at all, you're applying too much, try a different brush. And I haven't even got to this magical tool yet, but I will here in a second. I feel like a lot of product over here, probably way more than I'm gonna apply over here. I don't feel tacky. I cannot feel it on my skin, and that's the way it's supposed to feel. Another reason why I'm not a big fan of some of these brushes are that it lends to wanting to swipe into the creams, okay? Just remember, no matter the brush you're using, gently tap. Our creams are a little bit more tackier in consistency. Our contours, so our highlights are a little bit tackier in consistency. Our contours are drier, and they're designed to be that way. You just kind of got to learn the creams and how to dip into each one. They're all different. All right, so first up, highlights. I'm going to just barely touch my creams. Probably can't even see it on the brush, maybe barely. That's how very little I need. And then I'm going to hit this entire area of my face that has hyperpigmentation here, redness from my rosacea. I'm literally going to hit the entire side of my nose, since I already did that side, and a little bit in between my brows and chin and any blemishes, okay? Now, when it comes to color correctors in this method, the least amount of possible is what you wanna do. So I'm gonna buff it on, and this is gonna kind of tone out that hyperpigmentation and redness. It is not gonna completely cover it. You don't need full coverage within that first step, okay? So just a light hand of your corrector. Okay, I already did my eyes, so it's a little bit harder to get near my brows. I'm gonna go ahead and switch to the detail. Now, I love this brush, but I love the small ends for those small areas, especially because I'm trying to do half a face. I'm going to tap, 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 tap with very little pressure. And this is going to correct those small areas that that other brush just can't fit well. So I'm still using a buffing motion. I'm hitting the points of my face that either have the darkest hyperpigmentation, the most redness, that are just overall darker. Now I'm gonna hit my eyes. My under eyes, I am lighter, but you can see I have depth here. I have a lot of hyperpigmentation. I'm first gonna kind of tone that area and make it kind of match the rest of my face by just applying almost like a wash of my corrector shade across the whole area. Since I've got such light tones, this is almost like toning. Okay, so now I match more the rest of my skin. Then I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna tap in more, and now I'm gonna press. So with color correction, we always start with the lightest hand possible. Then we're gonna go in and we're gonna use a dense brush to then press on just where more coverage is needed. Not everywhere. Like, you don't see that my under eyes look orange, which is my number one comment about mango. They don't look orange. If you apply too much, they can. But if you're keeping everything light-handed, it won't, I promise. Okay, so I'm just gonna go back in and press anywhere I need a little bit more coverage that I have dark spots showing through. And that's it. Okay, so far I have one highlight shade on. You can probably see that I already have better coverage in some areas than this method. Now, if I were to apply that too heavy, it would actually pull me way darker than my neck. The rest of my body would show way too warm. But if you're strategic, use a very light hand, you will have to use less of each highlight shade than you would have to with one lighter shade. So I'm now gonna go into my main shade. This is gonna kind of tone down a little bit, but yet also build up my coverage a little bit. So I can easily get better coverage with these two. Okay, so again, I'm tapping, and then I'm just gonna tap on my skin, okay? Now this is going to not move that corrector because I am just tapping it on and I'm not doing the buffing motion. Okay, so anytime you want more coverage, remember to stipple. Smaller areas again. Same thing around my eyes, where I need more coverage. And this is also gonna allow my brightener shade to sit even better on my skin. So I'm going from this shade to this shade, and I'm slowly lightening that area under my skin so that this shade will sit better over this one. Hopefully that makes sense. Okay, same thing, you can press on more where you want more coverage. Okay. Now it's time to contour. Now, when I contour, again, since this shade kind of shows my dark spots through, it can tend to make my contour look patchy. It also will make my contour shade, which I use the most gray shade, meaning the coolest shade at my skin tone. It will pull this shade warm on me because I've got rosacea in this area. So I can get my contour to look more gray, which looks more like a natural shadow, when I put it over my corrector and main shade. It will blend out easier, and I can also not have it look patchy by having my hyperpigmentation show through. So I use the detail brush, and I do like to use it at an angle. I tap in And I am going to use this to apply and blend at the same time. Because I have all those areas under it, I do not want to have to do this motion at all, because I will just expose all of those dark spots. And then again, it's gonna make my contour area look patchy, not blending. So again, I'm strategic. I'm gonna place it right where I want. So right under the cheekbone. I start about the top of my ear, like I'm going towards my mouth, and then I stop applying right the corner of my eye, okay? It naturally blends in quite a bit, but you don't wanna get it in this area. And you want the ultimate lift to your cheekbones. You wanna stop about here, okay? So I'm just going to very lightly touch my face, okay? I'm gonna hold it at an angle, almost like I'm cupping that cheekbone. And I'm just going to lightly tap, okay? I'm not going too low, since this side got way too low. This side, I'm almost right on that cheekbone. You should be able to feel it with your brush, okay? Getting too low, shortening this area will just drag your face down. So we're just going to now start tapping along that line, okay? And now I'm starting to increase the pressure that I'm tapping. And now I'm gonna start pulling upwards as I tap to blend that line up. Okay, so we don't want like a really small, harsh line, which I feel like when we draw on with our fingers, it can be really easy again to like have that harsh line and be hard to blend it out unless you are doing this motion, right? So we wanna make sure, my gosh, I keep hitting my desk. We wanna make sure we fade that line as it's going up. Now, I like a defined contour, so I like to keep this line pretty defined, but I'll show you how you can blur it here in a second. So we just keep tapping up. And you can probably tell the difference. Now, I haven't fully blended this, but probably tell the difference in maybe my face. Okay, so grab your highlight brush, okay? Now here's where you can just easily tap right there. I don't like a harsh stopping point. I feel like then it makes your contour look very unblended, okay? You can also just take your brush and flick upwards like we did on the other side. To make sure that line is blended out. To diffuse this line, again, this time just tap, okay? Like before we carved out this side, you can do the same thing if you blend too much again and you want more defined contour. You can always use your highlight to carve it out. But in my opinion, it's easier just to gently blend and then blend with your highlight if you have any harsh edges, right? Okay. With forehead, which I forgot to even apply more over here, since I feel like it is barely visible, I do the same thing. I tap into my brush. Now I like to press on my forehead along that line. Okay, if you want to shrink your forehead, you can go down to your temples, but if you want to shrink it this direction, you go farther down on your forehead. Okay, now the key with foreheads is you wanna blend up into your hairline. Okay, and then you wanna pull down into the highlight because we don't want a defined forehead contour, only cheeks, okay? So now I feel like this side is framed out far better. It's giving me an illusion of a slightly shorter forehead, and I have a large forehead. I'm going to just apply a little bit more so I'm a little more even on this side. Okay, same thing with jawline, okay? Dip in, we're gonna go up under the jaw here, starting back at the ear, because that is where, just like on the cheek, that is where naturally our shadow would be the darkest, okay? Wherever you touch your brush first, after you dip in, you're gonna deposit the most amount of product there. So think of where would the shadow be the darkest? It's It's gonna be the darkest back here, and then you can pull it up. Blending it down the neck will make sure you're always matching. You're not gonna see a stripe on the side of your face. Now, the only time I go to the side of my face is if I truly have something I want to disguise, like jowls, and you have to bring up that product a little bit, but that's a more detailed video. I'm not even gonna get into noses right now. I don't feel like you can even possibly nose contour using the paint by method number. It's too hard to try to blend out these stripes with a big brush, but with this method, I'm gonna show you, just use your finger. Let's go ahead and just, now I did already highlight down the center of my nose. So, I don't know if you can tell. And since I didn't apply a corrector there first, it's showing some texture. Anywhere you're seeing texture with a highlight shade, apply a corrector or your main shade there first, okay? Number one reason of a shade showing texture is it's too light for that area, okay? So if you have areas of your face that are just naturally more textured and you have issues with pores or fine lines or any of those things, avoid those areas with your brightener. You don't have to apply a brightener to anywhere unless you want to. So now that we got our contour on, it is time to brighten this side. I am gonna use this small end of the detail brush so that I am not applying too much. With the brightener shade, it can be really easy to apply too much product. And again, too much of that lightest shade can also increase texture. So this method is hard to control with your finger. I use very little brightener now, and I feel like it sits better on my skin, doesn't emphasize my fine lines and wrinkles quite so much. So I'm gonna go ahead and dip in same color, but I'm just gonna be a little bit more strategic with placement. So since I did contour my nose slightly, I'm gonna put it up to that contour line on the side of my nose right there and right inside that tear duct. This is a nice flat part of the eye, so it's going to brighten really easily without showing too much texture. If you have mature skin like I do, you can avoid all of that areas where you tend to have the most texture and just bring it down closer to this side right here so that you are getting that pop of brightness without the emphasis under your eyes. Now, I know a lot of people like to brighten this side. I have a lot of crow's feet in that area. I feel like it emphasizes that area. Just because it's a trend doesn't mean you have to follow it, all right? So I instead focus on my eyes. Both of my eyes are different. And I like to brighten where I have a natural shadow. To me, it looks far better on my under eyes. So because I have darkness right there from that hyperpigmentation, you can kind of see, like, almost think of like where your eye naturally, your eye contours. Anywhere you have shadow, if you focus it on that particular shadow, you can get more of a diminishment, tricking the eye of that shadow or that contour, if you will, if you're just focusing it on strategic places instead of just doing the inner corner, outside corner technique. Now, I already brightened down the center of my nose. I'm gonna avoid this area. I did apply it on this side. I don't know if you guys can see. It's literally like sitting in my pores. If you ever feel like your highlight is just like looking like you have whiteheads inside your pores, that's a color too light. Don't use it there. Or you have to use a corrector and your main and then try it. And you wanna use very little. The more product you're applying, the more it will emphasize that. I tend to avoid this area. It's an area of my face that I do have pores and it will emphasize that texture. So I'm gonna skip that. I already got down the in between the contour stripes, if I can talk. Now I'm gonna do that Cupid's bow and then a little bit on my chin. And I go very light-handed on my chin because, again, I have pores. pores there. Now, if you have a lighter neck, here's where you can go ahead and press it along your jawline to bring in those lighter tones, or bronze down the neck. Either way, keeps you matching. This is the point of the process where I say, if you're using this method, it is a non-negotiable, you need to use your Perfector. I know so many people find this to be an optional thing, but in my opinion, it is not optional. It is the only way to remove excess. So if you've tried this method and you're feeling sticky or tacky and you're not using this because no one showed you how to use it, trust me, it's the only way to remove excess. And if you're using a brush like either one of these, I honestly have been an artist for 6 years. I can't apply with these brushes, even knowing what I know about exactly how much to apply, without using this. Can't do it. I will crease, I will feel sticky, I will feel heavy, and it's just not even possible for me. So my biggest issue is obviously around my eyes, and so this I am gonna focus there, but I use it across my entire face. Again, it's the only way to remove excess. So before I even sat down, I got this ready. I squeezed out every drop of water I could possibly get. I wrapped it in a towel. Now it is perfect. It is still very cold, but it is not damp. It shouldn't be damp. It should be cold. Damp perfectors will pull off your makeup. So if you are applying and you feel like you're applying a lot and you're using this and it's almost like leaving you with patches where it's removing the product, it's just too wet. A dry perfector can blend, but it truly doesn't remove excess. So it's the only way I recommend it, and I'm just going to pat. So I'm not gonna roll, I'm not gonna swipe, I'm just gonna bounce it across my face. And you'll notice I do this after highlights, before lip and cheek. Because lip and cheek pulls off, again, this is gonna pull off excess, and 9 out of 10 clients tell me their lip and cheek fades or they can't see it after 5 minutes. Usually it's because they're pulling it off or they're blending it away with their brush, or they're not giving it that, what I call the 5 minute die down time. Like 5 minutes, after 5 minutes, finish your face, see if you need to apply more. This method allows me to get exactly how much I want, and I know it's not gonna change. And this is why I always apply this order. Okay, now, since I do have, this is actually my bad eye when it comes to creasing. Since I do tend to crease so much, I focus under my eyes, I tap it out. If you don't know, creams don't set, meaning they will find the lowest valley of your face to settle. Your eyes never stop moving during the day. Your mouth probably doesn't stop moving a lot. And so anywhere you have natural creases in your face, the makeup will settle there. It's not gonna set. So it's not gonna dry down and just stay. That's a good thing because it doesn't crack, but that means that you have to set it if you don't want it to move. So the only places I set with a powder is around my eyes and my smile lines, or anywhere you don't wanna be shiny. So I grab that powder brush, I am barely touching, and then I'm going in and I'm just pressing right there. I take the excess down side of my nose, and then I tend to press in again and go smile lines. I don't like to be shiny between my brows, so I'm gonna take it right there, tip of my nose. Okay, I don't know if you can tell the difference between the two sides of how it looks. Now we need to finish the look with lip and cheek. I don't find contour looks very natural without lip and cheek. It's personal preference. So contour, lip and cheek, and then we're gonna finish with that illuminator. So same color, same method I showed you how to apply more over here. We're just gonna tap, and then we're going to go for the outside apple of the cheek right along that contour line. Okay, I'm barely touching my face to kind of gently blur that out. And there you go. Now, this is probably more like the amount I would wear on a daily basis than this is a little bit heavier, but you can apply more until they match. Okay, and my favorite method, which is putting something glowy over the top. So Dahlia is a matte. I like to always, I'm a layerer. So this method, you would have to then go back and you can't really, there are two ways of mixing lip and cheek shades to make your own shade. Mixing them, like dipping in both and then mixing, that's gonna kind of mix those formulations as well. If you're having longevity issues, I always recommend applying a matte first. Then if you like the glowy, dewy look like I do, then you can apply any of those glossy shades over it, and it's just gonna add that touch of glow to your face. So I'm gonna apply just a barely any La Cienega to get that glow to my skin, and I get the best of both worlds with that matte and that. If you've tried a gloss and it's too sticky or tacky, try putting a little bit of a pigmented shade under it. If you apply a large amount of any glossy shade, you're gonna be able to feel it. This method allows you to apply very little and you can still get the same end result. Okay, so the very last color of 3D foundation is that illuminator. I rarely see people put it on with the finger paint method. They usually touch, use their finger and do this. Now for me, maybe I'm a little too type A, it leaves fingerprints. So if I use my finger, I am really blending that out to make sure I don't have a mark where I touched. Like, I've seen pictures of myself where I have a fingerprint on my face with my illuminator. So I avoid that. I'm done with my Perfector, now I use it and I swipe in. It's one of the only things you'll see me swiping into, and I swipe in pretty generously. And so I got it on the Perfector. Then all I'm gonna do again is barely touch my face. And that way it is applied, blended at the same time, and you can most definitely see it. So when I hear from somebody that can't see their illuminator, I ask, how are you applying it? This method works every time. Okay, I'm just gonna finish with a little lip liner and lip color. I'm gonna use that same Dahlia. It's almost like a stain. Again, using as much or as little of these colors as you want. Same thing, La Cienega over it for the glow. Or in this case, a glossy lip. Okay, I'm just gonna fix this side real quick because I never perfected. I don't know if you can see the creasing. avoid the illuminator side. Now, since I know I have lighter shades there, powder does emphasize texture. It's just the nature of powder. You always wanna be as light-handed with powder under the eyes as possible, especially if you're using too light of a highlight shade. So I'm gonna just barely touch it so I no longer crease. And there you go. We've officially finished our look. So there is my method with a color corrector. Same colors, different application. Hopefully you guys can see the difference in, as I kind of talk about differences now. They both look good. I think we fixed this side so that it looks amazing, even, but hopefully you learned a few tips and tricks in order to kind of better improve your application, especially if you are brand new to Seint Beauty and 3D foundation. There are so many amazing ways to apply this makeup. The more you apply it, the more you're gonna learn and be able to tweak your own application so that you can get your absolute perfect look and whatever your preference might be. Makeup is such a personal preference. So whether you want full coverage or natural, different ways in order to get it, but hopefully you kind of picked up a few tips and tricks on how to avoid some common issues that I've seen throughout the years. If you have any questions, be sure to drop them down in the comments below. If you need help with your makeup or are in need of a color match or want me to verify that you have the right colors, I do it every day. Check out the caption below or the pinned comment. I will put my color match request. Just tell me how you like to wear your makeup and I will send you all of your best choices. As always, thank you guys so much for being here and watching. I will see you next week. Love you.